10.2 also. Okay, now angle subtended by chords. Okay, here is a theorem: equal chords of a circle subtend equal angles at the center. This is what is the important theorem, right? For the statement again, here is the picture. You can see the related figure: a circle, chords AB and CD, AB and CD. Okay, right. What is the statement we will see? Equal chords of a circle subtend equal angles at the center. Now, AB and CD are the chords of the circle because they are joining two points on the circle. See, here A and B are the two points here, and then C and D are the other points here, and they are joining. Of course, they are the chords. Let us measure and see whether the chords are equal or not. Yeah, chords are, each one is 3.41, 3.41. Therefore, they are equal. So, right, if I change this one, yeah, a change is happening in the other chord also. And you can see very well, the angle is also same all the way. Could you see the angle there? Is the angle changing?
Yes, sir.
One more thing you can very well assess, very well understand from this. Longer the chord, larger is the angle. Longer the chord, larger is the angle. And shorter, of course, short, and the angle is smaller, of course. It is understood. And equal length chords are subtending equal angles at the center. Okay? Now, this is what is proved practically. Now, we will prove it theoretically. Now, I removed the measurements. Let us understand what is given here. Center, circle with center O. Students, whenever we talk about a circle, we have to talk about its center, because that is the important concept for a circle. Center is the concept which is important for a circle, though it does not belong to the circle. To be frank, the center does not belong to the circle. It is a point in its interior, but still, depending on the center only, a circle is defined. AB and CD are its chords, and they are equal, of course. Of course, I did not write that. Are its equal chords, I have to write here. Are its equal chords. Let us write another step here, otherwise, we will write like this. AB equal to CD. That is given. Okay. All that is given. Now, what is to be proved? We have to prove that the angle subtended by these two chords, angle subtended by AB is AOB, angle subtended by CD is COD, these two angles are equal, we have to prove. For that, let us try to prove that these two triangles are congruent. Let us see how we can proceed with. In triangles AOB and COD, AOB and COD, AO equal to CO. They both are radii of the same circle. BO equal to DO. They are also radii. And given that AB equal to CD, therefore, all three sides of this particular triangle are correspondingly equal to the sides of this particular triangle COD here. Therefore, these two triangles are congruent by SSS congruence rule. Therefore, in two triangles, corresponding parts are equal, you know. Therefore, AOB, angle AOB is equal to angle COD. We proved it. Okay, very simple theorem, very important theorem. Okay, make a note of this one quickly. Equal chords of a circle subtend equal angles at the center. If the angles made by two chords are equal, is it true to say that chords are equal? This is what is called converse of the theorem. Suppose the angles made at the center are equal, then the chords, will they be equal? Yes. That is called converse of the theorem. If the angles subtended by the chords of a circle at the center are equal, then the chords are equal. This theorem is called converse of theorem 10.1. Of course, we need not learn the proof in all the with all the steps here, because that is only for learning the theorem here in your syllabus. But still, I would like to give you the proof in mathematical terms. You may remember this. Of course, it will not be asked in the exam, but still remember this, right? For proof, of course, we'll prove this one. Take the board a little upwards and circle I'll bring down so that you can see the circle, right? What is the proof? Yes, given that you know AOB is equal to COB, that is given, and you can very well prove in these two triangles now, AO equal to CO, BO equal to DO, because they are radii. You are given that this angle is equal to this angle, AOB is equal to COD. Therefore, these two triangles are congruent by SAS rule this time. Previously, they were congruent by SSS rule, and we proved that angles are equal. Now, angle is equal, we are proving that the sides of the triangles are equal. The sides are nothing but the chords. So, when two chords subtend equal angles at the center, the chords are equal in reverse. Now, theorem 2 also is completed. So, I will go to the next one. Next slide. Now, this is the exercise 10.2. Exercise 10.2, first question. Recall that two circles are congruent if they have the same radii. Prove that equal chords of congruent circles subtend equal angles at their centers. Now, instead of one circle, two circles are given which are congruent to each other. When are the circles congruent? Two circles are congruent when their radii are same. When their radii are same. Let us see, two circles we'll draw here. Circle O, circle with center O, circle with center O dash. In both these circles, AB is a chord in the first circle, CD is a chord in the second circle, but AB is equal to CD, that is indicated by this particular symbol here, AB equal to CD. Okay. We very well know that these two are congruent circles, that means they are equal in all respects. That means their radii are equal. AO here is equal to BO, we know they are the radii of the same circle. CO dash, DO dash are also equal, and CO dash and AO also equal because they are equal radii. They are equal because they are the radii of congruent circles. So we can very well compare these two triangles, AOB and CO dash D, and prove this theorem, prove this particular problem here, prove the equation given here. In triangle AOB and CO dash D, AB equal to CD, that is given, chords of same length, that those are given here. Then AO or OA is equal to O dash C, because they are radii of congruent circles. Similarly, OB is equal to O dash D, they are also radii of congruent circles. So again, the same thing. AOB and triangle AOB is congruent to triangle CO dash D by SSS congruence rule. Therefore, the angles AOB is equal to angle COD by what we know, CPCT, right? So whether the chords are of congruent circles or of the same circle, the same is the result. Result is not changing. In the theorem, we wrote OC, OD, that's all. Instead of O dash, that's all. Everything is same. So, theorem, first theorem number 1 and this question are the same. Okay?
Sure.
Yeah, you can note down now. Now let's move on to the next question here. Question 2 is based on hence equal chords of congruent circles subtend equal angles at their centers. Now question number 2. Prove that if chords of congruent circles subtend equal angles at their centers, the chords are equal. This also can be proved very easily. Now we have to we'll use the theorem number 2, that is the converse of theorem 1. So here what is given, let us understand. Again, two circles with centers O and O dash, they are congruent. These two circles are congruent and the angles here are equal. So I put them color pink in both. They are equal. Angles are equal. We have to prove that AB equal to CD. See, the previous one I'll show you here. Already AB is equal to CD, that is given. Now, in this, AB is not given as equal. Only the angles are equal. Therefore, again we proceed in the same way. We compare triangles AOB and CO dash D. And in these, angles are equal firstly, that is given. We know that OA equal to C, O dash C, because they are radii of congruent circles. Similarly, OB is equal to O dash D, congruent circles radii. Then, AOB, triangle AOB is congruent to triangle C, O dash D, by, it is actually SAS rule, children. I will change it. Yesterday I thought I could not. This is SAS rule. SAS rule. Okay? SAS. Side, angle, side. By side angle side rule, these two. This side is equal to this side because they are radii of congruent circles. This side is equal to this side. They are also radii of congruent circles. Given that these two angles are equal, therefore, by SAS congruency rule, these two triangles, triangle AOB and triangle COD, CO dash D are equal, are congruent. Therefore, in congruent triangles, corresponding parts are equal. Therefore, AB is equal to CD, CPCT. So, we proved that if chords of congruent circles subtend equal angles at their centers, then the chords are equal. Did you understand this question? Perpendiculars from the center to a chord. These three theorems, they don't need any proof. We just learn the theorems only. We don't need to prove them. We need not learn the proof of the theorems here. Okay, only we learn the statement of the theorem. The perpendicular from the center to a chord bisects the chord. The line drawn through the center of a circle to bisect a chord is perpendicular to the chord. There is one and only one circle passing through three non-collinear points. These are the...
Sir, please tell again, sir.
Only statements are important. Statements we have to study. We have to understand. Now, here we go. Of course, this view is not required, algebraic view is not required for you. I will close this so that the circle will be appearing bigger. Now, see here, the perpendicular from the center to a circle, of a circle to a chord bisects the chord. So, here is the circle with center O. AB is a chord and we have drawn a perpendicular from O to AB. That is OM. And we have to check whether OM is bisecting this chord AB. That means, bisecting means this these two parts must be equal. AM must be equal to MB. Okay? That is what is the thing. Now, let us see these parts here. AM. I have marked AM here now. AM is the part of the chord. Here I am going to put this one on BM. Now we are going to move this way like this. So it is the same now. You can see the observe, you can observe this one. So this way we can easily understand that perpendicular from the center to a chord bisects it. And the other way also you can say the other thing also is right. Children, today you take one circle and only take a bangle, draw a circle, try to find its center. First thing, how to find, you understand on your own. Tomorrow I am going to give you the answer for this one. So that is the homework for you today. The perpendicular from the center of a circle to a chord bisects the chord. Let's understand this. Now here is the thing. Right? Here, I have drawn a circle here. And AB is a chord. Of course, AB can be moved here and there like this. AB is a chord. And OM is a perpendicular drawn from the center. Perpendicular means it is actually a right angle. So OM, OMB, angle OMB or angle OMA, both will be equal to 90 degrees each. Okay, that is understood even from the drawing. Okay, you can see a chord can be having any length here like this. Right? This is the perpendicular. Now, is it exactly bisecting this chord or not? We have to check. For that, I want to find out the length of AM and MB first. Or I will measure AM like this. I put one pink colored stick on AM. Whether this pink colored stick is matching with MB or not, I want to put. I want to drag this side the same. I'm dragging this side. Is it exactly falling on MB or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Again, from MB, I will take it the other side. You can see the pink color is moving the other side now. Now the pink color is moving this side and the other side. So those two are equal. Those two are equal. Meaning this OM, the perpendicular, is bisecting the chord. Is bisecting the chord AB. Chord AB. That is understood practically. Now 10.4 we will understand. What is this 10.4? The line drawn through the center of a circle to bisect a chord is perpendicular to the chord. For that, let us draw a circle first. One circle is drawn. And a chord we take, CD is the chord. A perpendicular through the center I will draw now. This is the perpendicular through the center. Then, whether it is bisecting or not, I have to check. That means measure of CE equal to DE or not, I have to check. I am measuring. You see, now it is 2.56 and 2.56, thus measures of each of these line segments, CE and ED. Is it happening only for this particular chord or will it happen for other chords also? Let me check. See, I am extending the length of the chord even then. The same, that means halves are equal. Halves are equal. That means the perpendicular from the center is bisecting the chord. Bisecting the chord. Bisecting the chord, okay. The line, it is actually bisecting. And it is perpendicular or not, we have to check. This OE, is it perpendicular to DC or not, we have to check. How do you know whether it is perpendicular or not? We have to check the angle O dash ED, O dash EC, we have to check. If both these angles are 90 degrees each, then they are perpendicular. They are 90 degrees each. Okay, that means a line drawn through the center of a circle to bisect a chord is perpendicular to the chord. A perpendicular from the center bisects the chord. See, both these statements are true. We have checked these practically. This also practically we checked. Anywhere you take any chord, if the chord is bisected by a line drawn through the center, it will be perpendicular to the chord. Right? Then start this right. Two, three, yeah. Now, this is the point here. Through this point now, one more. See, through A, I have drawn a circle through A here. Okay? Through particular point A. Now, I have drawn another circle through A. circle, another circle, another circle. Concentrate on this point only. Through A, any number of circles can be drawn. Do you understand this? Any number of circles can be drawn through A.
Sure.
Now let us choose two points. Which and I will choose. I will draw a perpendicular here, and many points I will take on the perpendicular like this. And using these two points, many circles can be drawn again. Through one point, many circles are drawn. Through two points also, many circles are drawn like this. Now, through three points, how many circles can be drawn now? That is another question here. Three points I will choose. When I choose three points, what will happen? P, Q, and R I will choose somewhere. A circle is drawn like this. Okay, P, Q, R, a circle is drawn like this. Only one circle is drawn like this. Can I draw another circle through these three points, which is different from this one? I am trying to draw another. All right, it is again the same circle. It is not outside. First it is this, now it is this. Next, I will draw another circle. Even then, the circle is not different. So, what did you understand from this one? Through three points, three non-collinear points, that means all the three are not on the same line. All the three are not on the same line. Through these three points, only one circle can be drawn. See, I am trying to draw number of circles, but all those circles are matching with the first one only here. Okay, so through three points, if you think that I am doing a magic, I want to put three more points here. 1, 2, 3 points I put. I try to draw a circle through these points. 1, 2, and of course I am matching with this one now. With these three points, another circle I try to draw. This, you see, again it is coming the same. It cannot be anything else. It is the same. Okay, I will choose this time this and this. Okay, it is matching with the same. Are you able to understand this demonstration?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So through three points, only one and only one circle can be drawn. Therefore, this is what is identified here. Through two points, number of circles can be drawn. Through one point, many circles can be drawn like this. But if three points are given, following those, through those three points, only one circle can be drawn. Continue this. In this, now question 1 and 2 we'll check here. Exercise 10.3, question 1. Draw different pairs of circles. How many points does each pair have in common? What is the maximum number of common points? For this also, we'll find the answer on the GeoGebra screen here. Check here. I took one point. Of course, I am going to draw a circle. One circle is drawn. Another circle is drawn. And these are not having any common point. Do they have any common point? No. Therefore, they are called non-intersecting circles. See, I can draw the circles like this also. Even these two are non-intersecting circles. That means, either this pair or this pair, they don't have any common points. Therefore, they are called non-intersecting circles. Now, let us take another point here, and draw a circle, right? Another circle. These two points have one point in common here. See, these two circles have one point in common. Therefore, they are intersecting circles, intersecting at one point. Or we can say touching circles. They touch each other. See, either this side like this or like this, they touch each other. Therefore, they are called touching circles are circles intersecting at one point, we say. Okay, now can they have more points in common? Let us go search for that again. 1, 2, and I have drawn I drawn two circles which are intersecting at two different points. Here in the earlier case, circles are not intersecting at any point. Here in this case, intersecting at one point. Now the circles are intersecting at two points. Now, intersecting at two points. Do circles intersect at more points, more than two? It is not possible actually. If three points are taken and we try to draw a circle and only one circle we got it in the previous demonstration, right? We are trying to draw another circle, it is becoming the same, right? So through three points only one circle can be described. Therefore two circles can intersect at two points, maximum of two points. How many points maximum they can intersect at two points only. Two circles can intersect at a maximum of two points. So if you draw pairs of circles, either they don't intersect or intersect. If they intersect, they may intersect at one point or maximum of two points. If they intersect at only one point, we say they are touching each other. They are touching each other. Touching circles. They are intersecting circles here. Okay? Now, in the class, here I am taking one point. A circle is taken. It is a circle drawn just using a circular object, maybe a bangle or a plate. Outline of that one we have taken. For this to draw that, to find out the center, we need to take some points on the circle, join them. Two points you join, you get one chord here. Perpendicular bisectors of the chord you draw. You know how to draw perpendicular bisectors. And yes, I have drawn this. And these two bisectors will meet at a point that is the center of the circle. This is the center of the circle. This is how you can find the center of a circle.
Anywhere so, we can draw the chord, sir. Chord.
You can draw the chords anywhere you like. Anywhere you like. Okay, so do this one at home today. This is your homework today. So exercise 3 you have to complete in the classwork or homework, whatever it is. And third question is there, we will discuss that.